Geraldine Hickey.
Sup, fuckers. To start with, can I get a round of applause from all the people that are single? All the single people, round of applause. Yeah? 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 Suck shit. Yeah, suck a big one. Oh, no, you can't because you're single. Oh no. Oh. I'm not single. It's so great. How great has it been in a relationship? It's so good. So good. I'll tell you the top two best things about being in a relationship. Number one, lift to the airport. Every time. Like, how are you getting to the airport? Yeah, you're not going. That's right. Number two, best thing about being in a relationship? Someone to pick you up from the airport. Yeah? It's not all sunshine and lollipops, though. Like, sometimes relationships can be tough. Like, for example, sometimes when my partner and I, we travel together and we have to organise a lift to the airport. So, I tell you, I hate birthdays. Birthdays, for me, I hate the build-up to birthdays. Like, it's just... Like, it's so much for nothing, right? So much, like, you know what I mean? Like, leading up to your birthday, everyone's going, what are you going to do for your birthday? Are you going to do anything for your birthday? Yeah, no, I might do something. Yeah, come over for a drink. Yeah, bring them. I don't really know them, but yeah, bring them anyway. No, it's not a big one. Yeah, no. Yeah, just bring them. Yeah, well, I guess we could go out for dinner. Yeah, no, I'll get breakfast. Yeah, that's interesting. That's new. Yeah, we could do that. I guess we want to go for a movie. Parents, no. Like, I hate it. I hate it so much. Right, and on my birthday, birthdays for me, it's just a day of anxiety because I spend the whole time stressing over whether I should tell people it's my birthday. Do you know what I mean? Like, even, you know, when you get friends that find out it's your birthday, they go, why didn't you tell me it was your birthday? It's your birthday. Why didn't you tell me it was your birthday? How come you didn't tell me it was your birthday? I'm like, I'll tell you why I didn't tell you. Because it is impossible not to sound like a fucking idiot when you say, it's my birthday today. My birthday today. You can't do it, you know? And even, like, my last birthday, I was at the supermarket and I was at the checkout and I'm having an internal debate of whether or not to tell the checkout chick it was my birthday. Do you know what I mean? Like, just saying, just tell us your birthday. I don't know, she doesn't care. I'll just ask you how you were. She might be quite interested to know it's your birthday. Well, I guess it might be a good conversation starter, you know? Could be her birthday as well. I guess that could be interesting as well. Mind you, like, I'm at the self-serve checkout. So it's... really quite the debate going on in my head. But also, I'd like to start a campaign for equal priced haircuts. I'm just sick of paying more for a haircut because I'm a lady. Yeah? So, like, so many places, like men's cuts, $25, ladies' cuts, $35. Why? Why do I have to pay more? It's not like you have to cut around the boobs on my head. Do you know what I mean? Like, it's so ridiculous. And there's some places where I can't even go in there. I can't even walk in there. They go, oh, no, this is a barbershop. This is a barbershop just for men. It's just for men. Men only. This is a barbershop. It's a clip and shave. Clip and shave. Just for men. I'm like, all right, oh. Like, you could shave my beard if you want to while I'm in there, but I just want to get my hair cut. That's all I want to do. Like, what's going on in those places? Why can't I go in there? What's going on? Little secret room out the back? Is that what's going on? Little secret room out the back where all men go in there and just hold each other and cry because they might go bald later on in life? Is that what it is? Very sensitive about that, aren't you, men? You're very sensitive. Oh, don't talk about us going bald. Very sensitive. It's a very sensitive subject. Don't talk about us going bald. I'm very worried about this. Do you know what? Fuck you, yeah? You try walking around once a month, just casually checking the front of your pants, making sure there's no bloodstains there, yeah? And you're worried about the hair on your head, yeah? Also, later on in life, I'm going to go through menopause. I don't even know what's going to happen. All I know is one of the symptoms is a dry vagina. A dry vagina. Like, you know when you wake up in the middle of the night after you've had too many beers and you're like, I'm so dry. I'm so dry. That's going to be my vagina. And you're... all stressed about the hair on your fucking head, yeah? Also, you try walking around every day carrying a load of fruit on your chest. Just carrying a load of fruit, some melons or some bananas there. God, I don't know how they happen, but fuck, they're great, right? Just the fruit on your chest every day. Oh, yeah, love, I know what you're talking about. I know what you're talking about. I've got me bloody plums down here. Yeah, fellas, we all know about your plums. We know about them because you can't sit with your legs together on the train, yeah? Put your legs together on the train. There is room for two people on that seat. Put your fucking legs together on the train. Oh, no, I don't want to squash me plums. I don't want to squash me plums. Do you know what? You can't have me squeezing them into a pair of lycra pants and clip-hopping through the cafe every morning. That's not an issue, is it? Oh, you're fine with that. Oh, no, I don't want to squash me plums. Do you know what? If your plums are that big and important, why don't you lift them up, put your legs together, and then lay them on your fucking lap.